The thing I'm looking forward to most about being a Blue Hen, other than meeting the team, is the people. You know, I've heard great things about the community and the fan base, and I can't tell you how excited I am to get out there and meet people. In my spare time, when you have five children, you don't have a lot of spare time. So I find myself at volleyball matches and soccer matches and basketball games and everything you can imagine, golf. And I spend time with my kids and my wife, and I love every minute of it. I have some previous relationships who worked at Delaware. Kyle Flood, who's the head football coach at Rutgers, was the offensive line coach here when they won the national championship in 2003. He's told me many, many times what a special place Delaware is, and always talked about the people and the support. Jimmy Turner, who is the offensive line coach here, I think in 2006, he's the offensive line coach for the Miami Dolphins. I worked with Jimmy at Temple. He echoed Kyle's sentiments. He said what a terrific place it was, competitive players and future leaders. And they, you know, just talked about the fan base and the support being tremendous. I think the thing that's prepared me most for this role are the two opportunities I had to be an assistant head football coach. First at Hofstra for Joe Gardy. You know, I had a chance to see everything behind the scenes and the inner workings of a program that was in this conference at that time. And then I had an opportunity to be the assistant head football coach for John Bunning at the University of North Carolina. And that was tremendously eye-opening, the day-to-day operations and the staff issues and all the different things that go into being a head football coach was very, very enlightening, and it impacted my career going forward. Well, I think the challenge I'll have to overcome in the first 30 days is, you know, making sure that the players here understand that you know, they're my players and our players and Delaware's players. And then I have to go out on the road and recruit the young men who are committed and make sure that the recruiting class stays intact and that we're ready to go come signing day and the start of the spring semester. I think the most appealing thing about the Delaware opening was the opportunity to compete for national championships. When you can go somewhere and have a chance to compete at the absolute highest level on a consistent basis, that's a very, very rare opportunity in college football, and I'm very fortunate to have it. I just want to let the fans know when they come to the stadium that they're going to see a team that's going to attack on offense, defense, and special teams. We're going to go after people, and we're going to play a really, really exciting brand of football. Our team's theme this year will be Together We Will. I think it's important that everybody understands that it's a collective effort. It's going to be about the players. It's going to be about the administration. It's going to be about the student body. It's going to be about the fan base. And it's going to be about the people all across the country that are Blue Hens and making sure that we make them proud. My coaching philosophy is to attack. I think we want to be really, really aggressive in everything we do. And we want to teach the players exactly what we want done, and then allow them to do it, you know, and create situations and opportunities where they can maximize their potential and be successful. When you discuss making your players leaders, you have to empower them. You have to put them in a position where they can lead, you know, and you have to have confidence in the young men that they're going to make the right decisions and do the right things. We're going to create a culture of accountability at Delaware, you know, where those young men are going to understand that their actions are going to lead to our success. I think the importance of community outreach and relations is critical. I think when you're at a program like the University of Delaware football, where you have such tremendous fan support, that you're responsible to make sure that you give back and that you interact with the community that supports you so well. I think those who are fortunate enough to have much need to make sure that they give back. I hope that the Blue Hen Nation will come say hello to me if they see me in a supermarket, if they see me in a high school recruiting. You know, any venue that I'm in, I'm a Blue Hen, and I'm looking forward to meet people and say hello and share my vision. When I talk about my family, you have to make sure you have enough tape in the camera. My wife, Karen, I've been married for 16 years. I have five children, my son, Henry, my daughter, Kate, my son, William, my daughter, Maggie, and then my son, Richie. They are the absolute light of my life, and I'm very, very blessed to have them. I grew up in Morristown, New Jersey, and it had a great impact on my life. It was a tremendous community. I was surrounded by, you know, wonderful people. I had an opportunity to play youth football there, high school football there, and that really was my initial exposure to Delaware football. You know, when we were younger, being so close, you know, Delaware football had a tremendous presence in South Jersey. Well, football has impacted my life in so many ways. I've been very, very fortunate, you know, growing up and playing youth football and high school football and all those things, then to have the opportunity to get into coaching and then impact young people the same way I was impacted has been tremendous. And, you know, I've been fortunate to be at some terrific institutions, and now I'm fortunate to be the head football coach of one of the elite institutions in the United States. To follow such great coaches, legendary coaches, Hall of Fame coaches, is something that I will take very, very seriously, and I look forward to carrying on the tradition with Blue Hen pride. I'm Dave Brock, and starting today, I'm proud to be a Blue Hen.